As the case came up before Justice Alice Komuhangi, prosecution led by the state attorney Lillian O'Mara tendered a withdrawal letter of the case against the Rwenzururu King, Charles Wesley Mumbere, and the 217 Royal Guards, citing loss of interest in prosecuting the said case. The letter handed over to Justice Alice Komuhangi of the International Crimes Division of the High Court also indicated that Mumbere and his 217 subjects had sought amnesty from the government. Justice Komuhangi therefore dropped all the charges against Mumbere and the 217 Royal Guards, further ordered for the immediate release of those in prison.
Another prosecution serial number 3396, dated 13 June 2023, has been filed in the court. Consequently, proceedings against Mumbere Charles Wesley and 217 others, whose particulars and respective offences are on the lists which have been attached on the royal prosecution, are accordingly discontinued.
The state, however, maintained that the said charges against the former Kingdom Prime Minister Tembo Kasubire and one Mashereka Kamada. Their case has been adjourned to 11th July.
By discontinuing the proceedings against these accused persons, she has acted in accordance with the Constitution. In this particular case, the accused persons applied for amnesty to the Amnesty Commission, and the DPP received their applications for consideration. She found that they qualified under the Amnesty Act.
According to Tembo Kasubire, his lawyers did not engage him in the amnesty negotiations, leaving him to carry the cross for over 250 Rwenzururu royalists that were arrested.
What you have heard today is also news to me. Except I'm going to share it with my lawyers, who has been with me all the time, and find out the criteria that was used in dropping 280 and leaving me behind.
He didn't understand the meaning of amnesty. So when he told us he didn't understand the meaning of amnesty, he gave us time. He also left us to give him time. So perhaps when time comes and he realizes that he now understands, perhaps you also apply like others and go to freedom.
According to David Bwambali, one of the Rwenzururu Kingdom attorneys, the kingdom can now celebrate their victory after a seven-year legal battle to secure freedom for their subjects. King Charles Wesley Mumbere and over 300 of his royal guards were arrested and remanded to various prisons across the country following an attack on the palace in 2016 by the security agencies that left over 100 people in Kasese dead. They had been charged with terrorism, murder and attempted murder. He was later granted bail, but with his movements restricted, including not travelling to his kingdom. Prosecution had alleged that the crimes were indiscriminately committed without due regard to safety of others or property when the accused directly or indirectly involved themselves in murder of police officers, army men, members of the public, attacked various police establishments, on top of unlawfully making explosives and ammunition. Omusinga Charles Wesley Mumbere was alleged to have murdered police constables Simon Peter Apide, Saverio Ochema, and also attempted to murder Deputy AIP Dennis Ahewa and Police Constables Polike Ojoko and Francisco Simaki and Benon Biakin in September 2016. With the latest development, the Omusinga is now free to go back to his palace in Kasese.
People are celebrating. People are so happy with what has happened. It's unfortunate that we kept this information to ourselves. Otherwise, if you had relayed it to the public in advance, this place would be so flooded.
Report by Rachel Natchiwala for the news.